Welcome to this video playing Ferdia. Ferdia, let's see. An English defense. Yeah, it's New Year's Eve. I mean, not at the moment when I'm recording, but at the moment of release. And I'm on a winning streak of 13 out of 13. So, trying a run for this big 2500 rating. Yeah, he's playing a really good line here. Ferdia, did I say Italy? This is Ireland, of course. Did I say Italy? Let's see. 94. The English defense. It is a slightly shaky opening, but interesting to play. Let's see. Can I get some attack going against his center? White is not exactly perfectly coordinated. I'm looking at the g2 pawn, which is important. He cannot so easily develop. d4, queen h4 is an interesting move. Trying to threaten bishop. Yeah, queen h4, yeah. It's quite interesting. If he moves his bishop on f1, I take g2. And I'm threatening now bishop b4. Threatening, yeah, intending, let's say, and also knight c6 maybe, putting pressure on the d4 pawn. It's not easy to play this kind of position. The white center is somewhat exposed. Okay, if I go knight c6, bishop 2e3, yeah. Maybe bishop e3 d6, trying to be really quick here, yeah? Like if he takes, I mean e5 hangs, so he has to take care about it somehow, I think. And I, after taking bishop takes, I'm ready for long castles, which really looks quite nice, putting pressure on the pawn on d4. Yeah, that's not easy to play for white at all. Very often, white players who play 1c4, they struggle with the English defense here with b6, because it's sometimes really a little bit irrational and difficult to assess. And they don't get this so often. And in the English, you're very often, the English opening 1c4, you're very often used to playing a bit like pattern chess, yeah, which is not a bad thing. I mean, thinking in general concepts and so on. But in the English defense, you're sort of forced to, with b6, you're sort of forced to play very concrete stuff. That's interesting, actually. At first I thought that bishop g3 is just winning a piece, but he has h takes, of course. I can take, which is not bad. Hard to keep the queens on, really. Queen f6 looks kind of weird. Let's take it. I didn't want to trade queens, but okay. I still have the d pawn to play against. Rook d8. And possibly bishop e7, g6, bishop f6. Okay. Interesting. Bishop f3 is maybe coming. But let's start with this move first. Don't want the knight to come to f6 or something. And I can at least I have a nice time advantage. Okay, let's trade this thing. I also can play knight d6. Attacking his c4 pawn. I'm actually far ahead on the clock. That's nice. Knight a5 is also also a threat. This is a real threat. He cannot protect the pawn easily. And c5, you really don't want to play, giving me the d5 square. Oh, wow. Isn't a5 good now? a5 and then c5, okay. Okay, let's just do that. Attacking the a pawn here. It should be quite nice. a3 is hard to protect. You can play a4, but then a5 is just good. Okay, taking
check.
This. That's a good square. Protecting a7, but keeping an eye on d4. And d5 is nicely secured here anyway now. So rook d7, I guess. Rook d7, rook d8. Yeah, maybe just get the knight over to d5. Not totally sure about it. But he didn't even play knight f4, so. And he can play knight f4 now, but I have d5. Oops, what is this? Okay. This I didn't really think about at all. Yeah, I can really just take it. Bishop g5, king f8. Just take every pawn that's available. Now g6 gets me into an awkward pin, so I better do this. H5. Ah, yeah, h5, maybe rook g7 or something, trying to be a nuisance. F6. Yeah, f6. Hey, well, he's on 9 seconds, so I will win this on time, but I really am just a couple of pawns up. He has no real counterplay.
White forfeits on time.
Yeah, this was quite okay, I think. This was an interesting position out of the opening here. White is suffering a little bit with this exposed pawn, and queen h4 was strong with d6 coming. Knight c6, maybe d6 first, yeah, but this queen h5, but I think really here I'm okay. The computer actually prefers to castle long. Yeah, I didn't want to think about the g7 pawn going away. This is definitely an okay position for black. Here, but here he has to improve. He can do something like this, intending b3, and he shouldn't be in bad shape. I like to be black here, yeah, simply because I have an idea what to do, attacking d4 somehow, but white is of course totally solid. But with this, he invited me,
check.
And I took this invitation, picking up pawns in the process, and here it was really quite easily winning. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, and well, have a good New Year's Eve. Thanks for watching.